If y'all enjoyed today's video, make sure to do me a favor and drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Thank y'all so much for the continued support, and I'll catch you on the next video. Hey everyone, I hope you're having a great day. Late last night, Treyarch introduced an update that brought Season 2 into Black Ops Cold War. This update is available on all platforms, and it actually unlocks some of the content from Season 2, but the remainder of it will fully be unlocked when the update goes live tonight at 9 p.m. Pacific Time, 12 a.m. Eastern Time, and 5 a.m. GMT if you happen to be watching from overseas. This update not only gave us access to the Death Machine early, which you're going to see some gameplay of right here in this video, but it also gave us access to some of the new content in offline mode. That includes Outbreak and the new Fireteam map, Golova. I'm sure you're able to find gameplay of both of these on YouTube. I unfortunately will not be posting it until it officially drops just because it's technically not supposed to be available yet. I don't feel like getting a copyright strike, and I definitely don't feel like risking it. Let's talk about some of the things that we can see in game right now. So right off the bat, you're going to notice a lot of new loading screens. You'll also notice that the pregame lobby has changed pretty significantly. I called this last week when we saw that image of Samantha with a random dog. I said they're probably going to do what Modern Warfare did and add a character walking in a scene. And that's exactly what we have here. The really nice thing about this loading screen is if you don't touch it for about 30 seconds, it will actually go to a cinematic view where it hides all of the HUD elements and you just see your character walking through. The scene changes a little bit when you're playing zombies and it adds dark ether in the background. So overall, a nice touch. If you check the shop, there's a possibility that you may have a free bundle there. It's called the Outbreak Free Bundle. It includes an M16 blueprint, a Juggernog bottle cap charm, a calling card, and an emblem. When you click on this bundle, you'll notice that it says it's free, but then for some reason it also says it costs 1,300 COD points, which nobody wants to spend 1,300 COD points on a bundle that's supposed to be free. Taking one for the team and testing it for science, you could see that the bundle itself is in fact free. It didn't take any COD points, it didn't cost 1,300. This is simply a visual glitch, I would assume. There's most likely going to be a fix within the next few hours because something like this can tend to cause a little bit of chaos in the community, but I just wanted to mention that it is actually free. For some reason, it's just showing 1,300. Let's talk a little bit about the Death Machine. This is available in-game right now. It costs 2,200 score in order to earn it, and it is devastating. It has a lot of ammunition at its disposal. You can pull it out of your pocket, meaning you don't have to call in a care package in order to equip it or anything like that. This makes it a very good selection for anybody out there that's aggressive because you don't have to take time in order to call it in. It's just simply available whenever you want to use it. Now, the downside to this is once you start to use it and you get killed right off the bat, then you lose the streak. But if you're able to survive and continue your streak, it is extremely deadly, taking people out in 2 to 3 shots, and when those bullets are whizzing at a million miles an hour, it really does make things feel instantaneous, especially at close, medium, and longish ranges. Anything farther than that, you'll notice that there are possibilities to get hit markers, which is a little weird, but as long as you're able to keep everything centered on your target, they're basically just going to be eviscerated, and that's the best thing about the Death Machine. One more thing I should probably mention, the Death Machine works very similar to the War Machine in the sense that it is a great tool to have if you want to chain streaks together. Now, what I mean by that is if you have the VTOL or the AC-130 attached and it's a higher up streak, you can actually earn that because the Death Machine itself continues to carry your multiplier as you get kills, very similar to the War Machine. This is also a way that people are going to get their nuclear medals because it carries your streak. I like that a lot. I don't know about y'all, but 2,200 score to get this, and then being able to chain together some bigger streaks, this is a really, really nice thing to have. Another thing that you'll notice with this update, it added Samantha Maxis and Naga to our operators list. So if you go to the NATO side, you'll be able to see Sam's bio, and you'll also be able to watch her preview video, which is, I don't know, like many people say, oh, this isn't a big deal, it's just another operator, but to a lot of people, including myself, this is a huge deal. We've known Sam for, it seems like forever, but it's been nearly a decade. So the fact that we're going to be able to actually have her as an operator, not only to use in zombies, but also in regular multiplayer, that's really cool. And it opens up a lot of possibilities. Oh yeah, not to mention, she's going to be available in Warzone as well. So That's sweet. By the way, guys, but if you plan on picking up the Battle Pass, Sam when she releases next week, or any other operator that's going to be coming out over the next couple of weeks, please consider using my creator code, which is Prestige in all caps. Doing so goes directly to supporting me and my family. I thank you so much. Okay, so on the Warsaw side, we can actually see the bio and the preview video for Naga. He is going to be available when the Battle Pass comes out later tonight. And the thing is, with these connections to Perseus, we know he's the new bad boy character in this particular season. I'm very excited to learn more about this character as we move forward. And of course, the lore that we're about to get from Warzone, it's going to be pretty incredible to see what he has to do with the outbreak that's going to happen over there in Verdansk, if anything. Plus, I know that we're going to get some new cutscenes and whatnot through the mid-season update, so that's got me pretty stoked. Another thing that we're able to see early right now in-game are the new calling cards coming in Season 2. This includes the Outbreak calling cards, the Zombie calling cards, and the Multiplayer calling cards. Most of them look really decent, especially the Outbreak calling cards. They're super colorful. I also had a peek into the Prestige shop, and I noticed that they added a bunch of new Prestige and Prestige Master calling cards that are currently marked as classified. You most likely have to reach a certain rank before seeing those, or maybe they're just classified until the update comes later tonight. But I figured I would mention that anyway. There was one calling card that I was looking for in particular, but I was unable to find it. Maybe I'm just blind, but it is the Season 2 Prestige Master calling card. We were told in a blog post a couple of days ago that Season 2 will bring us a Prestige Master calling card once you hit rank 200. So I'm not entirely sure if it's just not going to pop up until you actually do that, or if it's just not there until the update truly comes out later tonight. I just quickly wanted to mention before we wrap up this video that I will have another video coming out a little bit later, probably within the next few hours. I have a sneaking suspicion that we are going to get a blog post about the upcoming Tier 4 and Tier 5 upgrades in Zombies. And when we do, I will make a video talking about how to get those upgrades, what the upgrades are going to do, and everything in between. Later tonight, when the update officially drops, I'll have Outbreak gameplay. We'll talk about what that's all about and how it works. I'll have the new Fire Team map. I'll also have some gameplay of the new multiplayer map. We'll talk a little bit about the Battle Pass. It is going to be a night filled with content. I definitely don't want you to miss it, so please do me a favor and ring the bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way you'll get notifications when my videos go live. We're going to have late night uploads all night tonight and into the early morning tomorrow. I want to thank you all so much for coming out to the video. If you enjoyed, make sure to drop a like on this video. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. Ring that bell like I said before. What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I hope you're all having a wonderful day. And in this video,